Surprisingly, and this is surprising even to me, because more than a year ago, maybe almost 2 years ago, feels that long, I made a YouTube video saying something along the lines of asking this rhetorical question. To me, it was a rhetorical question asking, where is the communication gone in social media networks like Facebook and Twitter and Friendsfeed and all that? Where is the communication? You know, that's kind of like how I rhetorically asked the question. And the surprising part that I want to start with this video, of course, is that I'm back on them. I've been back on them since like a month ago now. I recently joined back into the Twitter world and the Facebook world. I've actually started, joining other things. When I got my WordPress blog going, I don't know if that's actually kind of similar. I still got this YouTube thing going. There's this also thing called Instagram, which is an iPhone app where I can take pictures and I can filter them in. And the pictures that I take with my iPhone sort of act as kind of window into my life, which I think is a pretty interesting way to communicate with a social. I think that's an interesting social media tool. There's also of course Flickr, which of course is another picture device thing that kind of uses in that way. So I'm back on them. It's interesting to me because I thought I grew out of them. I thought I was disillusioned with social media networks. And that's really because I felt there was no communication. But I think I was looking at things the wrong way. You know, I was expecting that some kind of, you know, email or text message back and forth, this interesting dialogue that I would have with people, you know, meeting people far away and just being able to have a conversation, like asking them important questions, sharing their thoughts, and maybe on Twitter, stuff like that too. But then I realized, well, the way people use Facebook is with status updates and browsing photos. And the way people use Twitter is as an avenue for marketing and for spam. And I got tired of that, you know. That's why I quit. I didn't think it was useful for me anymore. But that's how I viewed it then. Now I have a different perspective on it, I think. Now the way I beat it, I think the way I beat it was kind of naive. In a way, Facebooking and photo browsing, that's sort of a way of to communicate as well. It's just not the way I was thinking it to be. You know, the idea of communication in my mind was just different. The picture of communication in my mind was just different from what it actually was. Same with the Twitter. You know, sometimes, yeah, there's a lot of avenue for advertising. But that's what people do on Twitter. They brand themselves. They sell their brand by having people follow them and showing them to links. And those links will earn them money because people click on the ads on the links and they'll get money for it, you know? So, yes, there's a lot of advertising. But in a lot of way, that advertising itself is communicating. And Twitter, more than anything, is less accurate to say it's communicating. It's more accurate to say that it's a stream or an exchange of information. You know, it's an information highway. There's so much information that is constantly streaming every few seconds, every few minutes, that, you know, 20, maybe like 90% of the information that gets put out in the day, you will miss out on. You know, it will just flip by you. But that's just the nature of that. You know, it just points you, directs you as a signpost to important articles, important information. And there is a way to communicate by retweeting, it makes us more aware of what's going on around the world. I think the way I use Twitter now, this is how I became aware of a lot of different issues going around the world, such as the demonstrations that happened in Egypt, in Tunisia, the whole Middle East eruption of fighting against dictators and for civil rights, for their political rights. You know, there's that thing. There's a whole community of vegan resources that exchange information that I really find useful. Political backhandering, like especially currently with the whole budget debate, just staying up to date with the world, and even finding good advice and finding good humor in Twitter is just incredible. So I definitely didn't see it that way before, and now I see it that way. And this will, and also, you know, if it's a marketing avenue, why not? Why not use it as a marketing avenue? And it's kind of what I do now. You know, every time I produce content, I link it to Twitter. And every day, like, it's a good outlet for me to just take my iPhone everywhere and just tweet about every little thought that I have, every, you know, kind of detail of my life, like what I'm doing right now, you know, what my day was like. It's an interesting way to kind of, you know, probably to 99% of the population, it's irrelevant information. It's useless crap, trivial information. But I always kind of try also to kind of add a little inspiring or thought-provoking thought into my tweets, even though they're just maybe as minute or trivial as me preparing a vegan meal and me mentioning what's in that vegan meal. But, you know, when I'm mentioning a vegan meal, maybe it gets someone who reads a tweet think about veganism or think about, like, what it likes is to be a vegan. So in that way, I'm always constantly exchanging information that way. And Facebook has grown so large. It's become such a big thing that it's now so hard to ignore. It's no longer just about the communication that I was mentioning. It's no longer about the status updates, whatever. But organizations are now, you know, like non-profit organizations, companies, different interests. You know, now there's such interconnectedness to Facebook. Now, ad campaigns, when you see a TV ad, it's going to say, you know, like us on Facebook, which I think is just demonstrates the profound impact of Facebook on our everyday lives. So that's why I'm back on it now. I mean, and Facebook is great because the status update in Facebook has just such different meaning on Facebook than on Twitter. On Twitter, it's an exchange of information. On Facebook, it's an invitation to start a discussion. You know, anytime I start a status update, you know, most of it's going to be ignored, which I think is I'm fine with. But, you know, people share their, it's more personal, so I'm more reluctant to post on Facebook because people on Facebook know me and I know them. And Twitter offers me anonymity, right? You know, not a lot, you know, all I know on Twitter are like, the people I follow on Twitter are like famous organizations, famous people, journalists, you know, experts, stuff of that nature. And people who follow me are spammers. They usually have like zero tweets or one tweet. They're just trying to follow me to lure me into following them, follow for follow, and therefore the more followers they get, the more they can spam and earn revenue for their advertising. I know how that works. Trust me, I'm on to you guys. But yeah, so there's, you know, so me on Twitter, I just tweet anything that comes to my mind. I'm really open to anything. On Facebook, I'm a little bit more reserved because, you know, I'm a little bit more worried about, like, my reputation, like, what would people think about the way I think about this. So I'm much more reluctant to post stuff on Facebook. But it is definitely an invitation. And it's, in a way, it's a sort of a communication because it lets me know how that other person is doing or feeling that day. And it also gives us the ability to share what we like. And the photo browsing, I think, is a good way to communicate, too. So now I have a different idea of what these social networks do. Before, I just saw it as it's not a good avenue for communicating. And I was only already communicating with my dear friends by email and phone. So what was the point? And I think I missed a key thing there, you know? So I didn't have Facebook or Twitter for, like, what, 3 years now, or 2 years, or whatever. When I came back, people thought I just came back. People thought I was dead or gone off the face of the planet, you know, stuff like that, which I just thought was hilarious. But yeah, it even in that sense, even if you never talk to another person on Facebook, it at least lets you know that you're alive. And that you're living life in some way. You know, there are very different ways to use Facebook and Twitter that I've never gave too much thought about. And I really, you know, dismissed it naively, I think. So I'm back on it now, I think. And it's kind of a job, in a way. I don't get paid for it, but linking all of my internet networks together and making the social networks work for me, it's quite a thing, you know. It's like marketeting myself, but it's also exchanging ideas, trying to inspire other people's ideas, trying to be inspired by other people's ideas. It's a very powerful tool, I think. These two networks have just become too big to ignore. Is pretty much my main point. They become too big to ignore, and it's to think them as useless is now not naive. It's they're useful in a way if used properly, if viewed properly. These are powerful tools. Twitter for one is a major component of the revolution that was started in Tunisia. People use these tools to overthrow dictatorships. That's something. So there's definitely something going on here that I really need to tap more into. And so that's just really what I wanted to talk about, how my view of these two networks has totally shifted. And now I'm trying to get more into what it's all about and trying to become more involved in this.